Beloved friends and viewers, welcome to my channel. My name is Jem, and in this channel I deal with topics about life and I deal with topics about death. I upload lots and lots of paranormal videos at night because I believe at night there's a lot of paranormal activity happening in my home. Now, sometimes I do humorous videos, and sometimes I try to tackle things that are really serious, like addiction, like illness, like disease, and other things. And today I'm going to tackle another very serious topic. Now, for those of you who know me, when I do these serious videos, I tend to save my speeches, my videos on another screen so I don't get my facts wrong and so the video flows. So today, this afternoon, Sunday the 20th of the 8th, 2023, 3:21 p.m. in the afternoon, we are going to delve into a topic that affects millions worldwide, yet often remains misunderstood, and that is chronic fatigue. This debilitating condition, also known as chronic fatigue syndrome, CFS, can significantly impact one's quality of life, productivity, and overall well-being. Let's explore its common causes, societal cost, prevalence among genders and age groups, associated disease, strategies for overcoming it, and potential dietary interventions. Now, I want to share with you guys that I suffer chronic fatigue. I have a lot of chronic illnesses. I also tend to be low in iron because I tend to be very vegetarian in my meal, although I will eat some meat. It's just very little. And I'm also lactose intolerant. So anyway, let's get on this. Common causes of chronic fatigue. While the exact cause of chronic fatigue remains elusive, there are several factors that could contribute to its development. Number one, viral infections. Certain viral infections, such as Epstein-Barr virus, which I've had, and human herpesvirus 6, has been linked to the onset of chronic fatigue. Now, the herpes virus is, you've heard of STDs, also chickenpox, also shingles. So the herpes virus has a wide range of viruses within the herpes family. Number two, autoimmune dysfunction. Autoimmune disorders like lupus or rheumatoid arthritis might trigger chronic fatigue as the immune system mistakenly attacks healthy tissues. Number three, stress and lifestyle factors. Prolonged stress, poor sleep, hands up, and an unhealthy lifestyle can lead to chronic fatigue in some cases. Guilty, I don't eat properly, I don't exercise enough, and I do not sleep well at all. Number four, neurological factors. Some researchers suggest that abnormalities in the nervous system could contribute to the development of chronic fatigue. Let's look at societal cost and prevalence. So chronic fatigue exacts a significant toll on both individuals and society as a whole. The economic burden includes medical costs, reduced productivity, and missed work days. Globally, it's estimated to cost billions of dollars annually. Let's look at gender and age disparities. While chronic fatigue can affect anyone, it appears to be more prevalent among females. Studies have shown that women are diagnosed with CFS more often than men, though the reasons behind this gender disparity are not yet fully understood. As for age groups, it can affect individuals of all ages, but it's most commonly diagnosed in people aged 20 to 50. Well, I'm 62. Associated diseases. Chronic fatigue can lead to a range of other health issues, including fibromyalgia, irritable bowel syndrome, and immune system dysregulation. How to or overcoming chronic fatigue. Overcoming chronic fatigue can be a complex journey, particularly when it's caused by underlying illnesses or autoimmune deficiencies. Here are some strategies. Number one, rest and pace activities. Managing energy levels through adequate rest and pacing daily activities is crucial. Number two, stress reduction. Techniques like meditation, deep breathing, and mindfulness can help manage stress, which is often linked to chronic fatigue. Number three, physical activity. Engaging in gentle exercises such as yoga or walking can gradually improve stamina and overall well-being. Number four, support networks. Seeking emotional support from family, friends, or support groups can alleviate feelings of isolation. Let's look at nutrition and dietary interventions. While there's no definite cure, some dietary interventions and supplements might help alleviate symptoms. Number one, vitamin B12 and D. Now, I get vitamin B12 injections. These vitamins play a role in energy production and immune function. Number two, omega-3 fatty acids. Found in fatty fish and flax seeds, these can have an anti-inflammatory effect. Number three, anti-inflammatory foods. Incorporating a diet rich in fruits, vegetables, whole grains, and lean proteins can help reduce inflammation. Well, I'll have to start improving my diet, won't I? Yes, but it's all about money and having the money. You know, it's well enough to say we should eat a well-balanced diet, but sometimes, thanks to greedy corporations and supermarkets, that's just not possible. And sometimes we have to take multivitamins. Anyway, in conclusion, chronic fatigue is a complex condition that impacts individuals physically, emotionally, and economically. While there's no one-size-fits-all solution, understanding its causes, seeking proper medical guidance, and adopting a holistic approach to management can pave the way towards improved quality of life for those who are affected. Thank you, guys. As always, cherish every moment, love the best you can, and every life matters. And just on something, I've noticed that I get very tired. And when I'm tired, the more I sleep, the more tired I get. So in other words, I wake up in the morning and I'm tired and I just go back to bed, I get even more tired. But if I get up and try to overcome that tired by having something to do, that is very helpful. So things for me, like knowing that I've got to go to do voluntary work, that is very helpful. With, you know, having things in place to do, that, you know, overcomes boredom. Boredom is another thing that can lead to chronic fatigue. Having nothing to do can lead to being easily fatigued. All right, I've said enough. This video is now done. Love you. Have a good one. Goodbye.